All right, so it's great that we can visualize the winning percentage of the Red Sox from 1960 to 2010. But what if we wanted to do a slightly more complex analysis to try to understand what is driving that winning percentage? We'd have to incorporate more variables, but how? One way is that we can use the visual cues that we're familiar with to encode even more information into the chart. For example, let's go back to our scatter chart. We can use the size of the points to represent the number of home runs hit by the Red Sox players that year. Dots that are larger meant that more home runs were hit in that year, whereas smaller dots mean that fewer home runs were hit. Hopefully, what we would see is that bigger dots occur when the winning percentage is higher. I've filled the plot in with some dummy data just so that you have an idea of what this might look like. We could even double up on visual cues. For example, maybe we also use the saturation of the red color to indicate how many home runs were hit. So our larger dots will be a more intense shade of red, whereas our smaller dots will be a less intense, maybe almost pink shade of red. A redundant visual cue can help reinforce what might be a challenge to see if we only used one visual cue. So by using both size and color here, hopefully we really hammer home to the viewer that there were more or fewer home runs in a given year.